Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Loreen HD for a new video on sex menus, which will help you get to know your sexual self better and help your partner or partners give you the pleasurable experience you're seeking. But before I get into sex menus, I just want to give a shout out to Lovers and Friends, where I had the chance to hear about sex menus. So Lovers and Friends is an online social club where a community of curated folks discuss anything from sex, intimacy and relationships, and I have become an ambassador for the platform a few months ago, and I have to say I really enjoyed the kind of conversations that were held on Lovers and Friends, but also the points that were made and the openness that you don't necessarily find in the people who surround you. So if you're curious about Lovers and Friends and you want to give it a shot, you can use Loreen HD for 50% off your first month and maybe see you on Lovers and Friends. All right, so sex menus. In this video, we're going to see what a sex menu is, why you should have one. We're going to review a few templates of sex menus just to spark your inspiration to craft your own. And then we're going to see a couple ideas for how you can share it with your partners if that's what you want to do. All right, let's get into it. So what is a sex menu? A sex menu is a document where you state your preferences, your boundaries, your sexual health information, your turn-on, your turn-offs, anything that might affect your sexual experience in a positive or negative way. So essentially, it's a great way to establish a common ground on how to give and receive pleasure during a sexual encounter. And lastly, it's a living and breathing document as opposed to a set in stone declaration. Why? Because this document evolves and it changes as you change. So it's a good idea to keep it in an editable format, like a Google Doc, for example, so you can tweak it according to your mood or according to your partner before sending it if that's what you want to do. So now you might wonder, should I have a sex menu and why should I have a sex menu? Listen, your sexual life deserves as much introspection and reflection and attention and insight as other parts of your life, say your career, your relationships, your love life, or any other part of your life that you might already be living more mindfully. So whether you decide to share it or not, just doing this exercise will bring you more awareness of who you are as a sexual person, what you like, what you don't like. And this awareness will inherently empower you to get the sexual experiences that you want. So, if you do share it with partners, at best, it will give you awesome sex. And at worst, it will prevent bad one from happening. So by now, hopefully you are on board with trying to write your sex menu, but you might feel a little bit overwhelmed or lost on how to structure it. So let's review a few templates to get your inspiration going. So this first menu I found online, and as you can see, it follows the typical framework of a regular menu. It has appetizers and starters and mains, and it gives a good idea to your partners. One, the type of activities that you're into. Two, the weight that each of these activities have for you, right? So foreplay can be a main for some people and it can be an appetizer for other people, and your partners can't know that if you don't tell them. And three, it can just help them really orchestrate your sexual crescendo. I'm assuming that this is more of an a la carte menu where you wouldn't do all of these activities in one sexual encounter, but this will be invaluable for your partners to know what to pick and choose from. And again, the weight that each of these activities has for you. And obviously, you know me, this can also be a great place to put sexual health information. So do you have any requirements for STI testing? For example, partners to be tested in the past 3 months or 6 months or a year, you name it. Barrier methods, do you have a preference for barrier methods and are you adamant about them? Maybe for which type of activities are you adamant about them? Lube, what kind of lube do you prefer? Do you like to apply it on yourself, or are you okay with partners applying it on you? Basically, you get the idea. It can be as specific and granular as you want it to be, but just to really understand that this doesn't have to be only about pleasure, it can also be about health, because as we know, the two go hand in hand. And lastly, if you have any disability or condition that sex might impact, this is also a great place to put it so that your partners are aware of movements to avoid or prioritize, and so on and so forth. Moving on to the second template of our sex menu. So as you can see, this one is less of an a la carte and more of an actual menu. It has less options, but it is more specific in terms of the activities that you would want to enjoy with your partners, as well as the ambience that you would want to curate around those activities. Since it includes less boundaries and guardrails, I would think this type of menu is more appropriate to send to people with whom you've already had sex encounters before and with whom you know some of the parameters around what you enjoy and what you don't enjoy, you're not comfortable with, are already established. And it can be a great way to spice things up a little bit by being really specific about the type of activity that you would want to enjoy with them. And here's a third and last example of a template that could inspire yours, courtesy of sex educator and professional dom Lola Jean. This one, as you can see, goes less by timeline of activities and more by desired outcomes in terms of feelings. You might check all that applies before a sexual encounter and send it to your partner because, you know, what you might want to get out of a sexual encounter might differ according to, you know, time and day and mood and many other things. Since it doesn't include specific activities that you enjoy, this one can feel a little bit less daunting to send to partners. So partners would know, okay, they are into something a little bit more, you know, rough, or maybe a little bit more intimate, or a little bit more playful, or whatever it might be that you are in the mood for, and leaves them the sort of, let's say, creativity to get there, but they know what they're working towards as a feeling. Just like sexual health information can be a great addition to these sex menus, make sure you include verbal communication as well, right? Things that might come up in dirty talks. For example, or good girl, like, are these turn-ons for you or turn-offs for you? We know the power of communication. We know how they can, you know, set you off or completely shut you down. So make sure that all of these are also included in your sex menu. So now that you have a few examples of templates, you might need some stimuli to actually fill it with. And good thing Scarlatine has put a stock list of activities through its yes, no, maybe list. So you now have a template, you have stimuli to fill your template with. Let's say you've written your sex menu and you feel great about it. One thing remains, how do I send it to my partners without feeling awkward about it? One thing I want to reiterate is that you do not have to send the actual menu to your partners. You can use your menu as a basis for conversation about sex with them, okay? So you can, for example, ask them, what arouses you during sex? How do you like to feel when you have sex with someone? What are sides? What are mains? What are no-nos? And the perks of having done your sex menu is that you will already have answers to all of these questions and you won't be caught off guards or having to answer in the heat of the moment. If you feel awkward sending it because it contains a lot of very personal information, which is totally fair, and you feel like this partner doesn't feel quite safe to receive your sex menu, you can also make a dietary restriction menu, which is a code word for things that are off the table, like things that are no-no. Because sometimes saying what we're not into feels less risky than saying what we actually are into. So maybe you feel awkward because you're like, what kind of conversation do I need to have for sex menus to find its natural fit in there? And in that case, one thing you could do is to sort of flip the roles, and instead of looking for an opening to send it, you might instead ask your partner for their sex menu. So hear me out. Let's say this is already like a flirtatious interaction happening between the two of you, and you could say something like, my brain is playing so many fantasies of the two of us in bed. If you sent me your sex menu, I could make them a little more real. And then they would be like, sex menu? What's a sex menu? And like, good thing you already know everything about sex menus. So you would tell them what a sex menu is, and eventually they would ask you, do you have a sex menu? Well, good luck, yes you would. Lastly, I want to make sure that you all know that sex menus are not take it or leave it documents. They can be up for negotiation. So when you're crafting it, think about the things that are absolute yeses, absolute nos, and things that are maybe that you might want to have a conversation with your partner and see how they would explore that with you. Also, it does not replace consent. Anything that you might have put on the menu is 100% revocable, retractable. I don't know what is the word, but essentially you do not have to obey to the things that were on your sex menu. Like, sex menus are here to serve you, not the other way around. So you want to make sure that anything that was on the sex menu is still vetted through consent in the moment. Same thing for your partner. If they have sent you theirs, you want to make sure that they are still into doing the things that their sex menu outlines. Okay, now I'm curious, from 0 to let me do it right now, how inspired are you to craft your own sex menu? And for those who are avant-gardists and already have a sex menu, let me know, how did you structure it? How are your partners receiving it? Has it actually helped you to get the sex life that you wanted? Let me know everything in the comments below. And that's it. Thanks for watching. Leave a thumbs up if you found this video valuable. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to my channel through the subscribe button that will appear in 3, 2, 1.